Welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Myrie. Today's topic, the antidote for the snake's attack. And the Lord said unto the serpent, because thou hast done this, thou art cursed above all cattle and above every beast of the field. And upon thy belly shalt thou go, and thus shalt thou eat all the days of thy life. And I will put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed. It shall bruise thy head, and thou shalt bruise his heel. Genesis 3, 14 through 15. I don't know about you, but I hate snakes. There's something about a slimy, slithering serpent that I do not care to be around. And there are many persons who feel the same. There's a possibility that the reason we humans don't like snakes is because way back in the beginning, God put enmity between them and us. God from the beginning referred to Satan as being a serpent. After Satan posed as a serpent and seduced Eve into partaking of the tree of good and evil, God said there would be enmity between Satan and mankind from this point forward. Enmity means active, typically mutual hatred or ill will. I want to tell you today without reservations, I hate the devil. I hate him for what he's doing in the world today. Lying, killing, stealing, destroying lives all over the world. He's even responsible for this pandemic. But I also know that he has equally a mutual amount of hate for me as well. He would love to see me fall. He would love to see me lose this war. Ever since creation, there has been a battle of epic proportions taking place. Although sometimes it looks like Satan is causing more damage than we are causing him, I want to share with you what the word says will happen when we fight the enemy. In Genesis, Satan is referred to as a serpent. In 1 Peter, he is referred to as a roaring lion. And in Revelation, Satan is referred to as a dragon. It seems like as time progresses, Satan is becoming bigger and stronger. But notice what David said in Psalm 91 verse 13. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and adder. The young lion and the dragon shalt thou trample under feet. David reinforced what God said in Genesis. No matter how big and strong the enemy becomes, God will give you enough power to keep the enemy under your feet. I still claim the promise of Isaiah 54 verse 17. No weapon that is formed against thee shall prosper, and every tongue that riseth against thee in judgment thou shalt condemn. I claim the promise that as a child of God, I have the power to overcome Satan. How do we do this? What do you need to do to overcome? In Egypt, there is a mongoose known as the Egyptian mongoose. It can destroy and overcome a venomous snake even 3 feet long. It is said that the mongoose attacks a snake only when it is near a certain plant whose leaves contain an antidote for a snake bite. When bitten, the little creature immediately retreats to the life-saving plant and nibbles its leaves. It is then restored and ready and renew the attack. Each time it is bitten, it then goes to the plant and then returns to fight its enemy. We are in a fight with the enemy, the devil, for our families, for our relationship with God. It's a no-holds-barred war. He will come against you with anything and everything that he possibly can. He will use work situations and family members, and yes, even church people who are not completely sold out to God. I will tell you that if you fight with the devil, sometimes you will get bitten. But as long as you stay close to the life-giving force, which is God himself, every time you get bitten by the enemy, God will heal your wounds and give you the strength to fight again. Don't you just stay lying down and die when the enemy attacks? When you get attacked, somehow, some way, you need to find a way to God. Get a little more of God and then go back and put up a fight. Today we have an antidote for Satan's attack. And I want us to find our way to the life-giving force by falling on our knees and getting more of God today. If the enemy has been attacking you, please find the healing and strength that only God can give. The thought of the day, I claim the promise that I, as a child of God, will overcome that serpent Satan. God bless you today, in Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, life. light and the darkness.